Hello everybody, welcome back again. So now there is a third session with the 19 presentations over there. So I would like to name the presenter who will hopefully hear with us. That is Dr. Orpita Chatterjee, Dr. Swati Ghosh, Ms. Sharbani Banerjee, Dr. Anit Soni, Mr. Prosenjit Pramanik, Ms. Payal Sarkar, Dr. Mohammad Asif Iqbal, Dr. Abhijit Datta, Dr. Sonali Dapse, Mr. Sujan Bandhu Chakraborty, Dr. S.J. Jain, Dr. Shapon Khan, Ms. Anindita Chakraborty, Mr. Sahil Vains, Dr. Meghna Dhar, Mr. Uddalok Shaha, Mr. Subhashish Chatterjee, Ms. Rajashree Sheena, and finally, Mr. Hafizul Mondol. And another announcement I would like to share with you, that the person who was interested for the to chair the particular session, the session 3, cannot attend due to some family issues. So here, we will continue the session. I will coordinate on behalf of him. And another thing is that it is 3 p.m. So we want to complete it within 5:15 or 5:20. So if 19 presenters are there, so if 6 to 7, 6 minutes each can be allotted, and please remember that focus on your primary findings and objective of your presentation. Do not elaborate it unnecessarily so that others do not get the chance to present his or her topic. Okay, so is Orpita ready? Orpita madam?
Yes.
Okay. Then let's start with Dr. Orpita Chatterjee from Barashat College, West Bengal. Madam.
Yeah. I'm trying to share my screen. Please allow me. Is it?
No, it is not visible yet. Orpita?
हेलो
हेलो
जयदीप सर, आई एम नॉट एबल टू शेयर माय स्क्रीन. कैन यू हेल्प मी इन दिस रिगार्ड? कैन यू शेयर माय स्लाइड सो दैट आई कैन कंटिन्यू?
जस्ट होल्ड ऑन. Is it visible?
I can't see.
Other participants, is it visible?
Yes.
If it is visible, then I can.
Okay, it is visible.
Okay, and I will continue. Okay, thank you, sir, for giving me the opportunity to present before you my topic of discussion for today is online education, merits and demerits. Okay, sir, please go to the second slide. Actually, in this COVID-19 situation has a deep impact to our society and on mainly on our education system for students and teachers in different way globally. Okay, sir, please slide two. In pre-pandemic situation, educational institutes like school, college, universities in India are based only on traditional methods of learning. They follow the traditional setup of face-to-face lectures in classroom, and that was a traditional way every institute follows. Okay, but in a pandemic situation after COVID-19, it has challenged the education system across the world and forced everyone to go for online system of education. Okay, and this type of system of education is a new thing for us. Okay, next slide, please. Right, there are currently more than 1.2 billion children in 186 countries affected by closure of school in this pandemic situation. It is a research result, and it was seen that 91% of world student population affected by current closure of school. And in another study, it was found that 1.6 billion students are out of school, and of which 743 million are girls. So we can see a gender inequality in education in online platform. So for the transition of classroom to online platform, it has hit everyone, especially the school age children and children around the world. Okay, please go to the fourth slide. We will just focus on the demerits and the challenges for the online situation. Actually, there is a gap between students from privileged to underprivileged background to afford all the necessary for e-learning platform. Actually, in student from different income brackets show different types of situation for having online system. The stitching during pandemic is very difficult. Please go to the fifth slide. What are the challenges for this online learning? Some students without reliable internet access and technology struggle to participate in digital learning. The student living in poor economic status cannot afford the cost even. The difference in the capacity to update with this new normal education system pushed a group of students in a corner. The effectiveness of online learning also varies amongst the age group. Actually, in case of kids, they mainly need direct for special children, they need much more attention and face-to-face learning for their problem. Okay, so these are the challenges, but what are the merits? Actually, it was found that in many researches suggest for those who have access to right technology, and evidence, it was evident that this learning system in online can be more effective in number of ways. Students retain 25 to 60% more material compared to regular classroom system, where it was found that 8 to 10% retention is there. And student learn faster. E-learning required 40 to 60% less time to run. Okay. So e-learning is not at all a bad thing. We can consider that it is a best way if we can take it in a good way. But here is something I want to mention, that boys are 1.5 times more likely to own a phone than 8 times more likely to have access to internet than girls. So we can conclude that there is also a gender inequality in education system for online learning in the poor and lower middle income groups, and this difference is also pronounced in different countries and different social economic status. According to OECD data, 95% of students in Switzerland, Norway, and Australia has computer facility for their school work, 74% in Indonesia. In US, significant gap between privileged and disadvantaged background was observed. Virtually 15 years old privilege has a computer, really 25% of disadvantaged background did not have this. Some institute have computer facility to student. In India, this in situation is much, much, much bad. So here is a gap between a privileged group, and they can afford the cost and they can afford the technology. So this is good for online learning, and e-learning is good for them. And for lower economies group, it cannot be good. So some of the academic institution has started blended learning, regular learning with online system as a secondary choice. Still a lot of work have to be done, and there are so many other programs in from government and non-government education system, and it has launched many language apps, virtual tutorials, video conferencing tools, and global edtech investment has reached much more in case of online system. In 2019, it was in US dollar 18.66 million, but in 2025 it was seems to be nearly up to 350 billion in US dollars. So online platform is good if we can afford it. So it is our new normal education system. We have to accept it and have to convert it our dimension of teaching in that platform. That's all. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, madam. Now I request the participant to raise any question or observation, because it is all of us now. No senior person is there. So don't hesitate to ask your query or suggestion to the speaker so that it will be more interactive. Right. Dr. Orpita Chatterjee, Dr. Asif Iqbal has raised a question that what is the data source of your findings or the statistics you have provided over there? Dr. Chatterjee?
Am I audible? Yes, sir.
Yes, you are audible.
Actually, I am facing huge internet problem today.
Yeah,
sorry.
Your voice was also breaking down at the time of presentation. Yes. Anyway, madam, Dr. Asif Iqbal has raised a question that what is the data source of your presentation? Means the statistics you have provided.
Actually, sir, I have taken information from internet and available documents in e-education system. Okay, it is not my research work. I have it is a review work. So I have taken all documents from website and internet.
Okay, thank you. I think Dr. Iqbal has got his answer. Now, may I request Dr. Shati Ghosh, an old friend of mine, to share his presentation.
Good afternoon, everybody. First of all, I am thankful to the Central Library, Barakpur Rashtraguru Surendranath College, and all the support team regarding this webinar e-learning experience. I also thank our respected resource person also. Now I am Dr. Shati Ghosh, librarian, Savitri Girls College, presenting my paper through this web platform. My paper is on paradigm shift in the learning environment. Is this visible?
Yes, madam, it is visible. Oh,
thank you. We all know that digital technology has now become play an important role for the new normal situation. After the outbreak of COVID-19, normal life was drastically changed, and its impact on education and learning system was also very much important. Before the outbreak of COVID-19, we all know that e-learning is important aspect mainly used in the field of open and distance learning system, where it promotes education to cross the four walls of educational institutions and for the educational and scientific research also. Digital technology is helping as a boon to know about the investigation going on all around the world, and it enriches the field of knowledge society also. But after the COVID situation, online education become the best possible solution for the entire teaching learning community. Now, the learners have greater choice in terms of their curriculum, and at the same time, 24 hours online classroom become a hardcore reality also. Network technologies and the new educational methodologies have empowered the learners as well as the provider also, giving them a greater measure of control and participation in the learning process. Now, the difference between traditional system and the new situation. Traditional information environment, where users can receive information by searching catalogs, indexing of the books of the organized knowledge. In the new normal situation, the subject-based information gateways can provide information by classifying and cataloging the internet resources, that is online resources, to help the user community for the retrieval of right information within a fraction of a second. Now, first of all, what are the advantages? Obviously, first and important advantage is efficiency. Online learning offers the teacher with an efficient way to deliver lesson to his or her students. Online learning has a number of tools such as videos, PDFs, podcasts, and teachers can use all of these tools as a part of their lesson plan. By extending lesson plan beyond the traditional textbook, it also includes online resources and teachers able to become more efficient educator. We can also see that it is the easy access of the data handling. Technology can create new path in the field of modern education system. Student can easily access various information by using technology for their educational purpose. It is also minimize the time frame of their work. Student can also compare several data regarding the particular matter of their field. Next important is accessibility of time and place, and at the same time, easier and faster communication. By the use of technology, student can also contact with the various persons in the different parts of the world. They can meet them via video conferencing and share their ideas, knowledge regarding various educational topics. It also helps students to enrich their concept and also connect with a new way to help education system also. Thus, online system offer the students in the accessibility of time and place of the education system. Now, the affordability. Another advantage of online learning is reduced financial cost in some times. Online education is far more affordable as compared to physical learning. This is because online learning eliminates the cost of printed books of students and also the students' transportation, students' meal, and most importantly, real estate. Additionally, all the course of study materials are available online, thus creating a paperless learning environment which is more affordable while also being beneficial to our environment also. It is sometimes independent learning. Yes, technology can help students to learn freely and know freely. The internet helps students to fulfill their quest of knowledge, and student can enjoy learning process without any pressure of formal class textbook. The internet also gives the students updated information in their particular field. Next, improved student attendance. But in some cases, it also varies. Since online classes can be taken from home or location of choice, there are fewer choices that students are missing out of their knowledge. Lesson plan also. Now, new way of curricular transaction. Technology not only helps the students to get new knowledge, but it also helps teacher to find out new way of curricular transaction. Now, the development of new teaching method. It is very boring. In some cases, student is continuously hear the teacher's talk. Technology can help the teacher to innovate few new teaching method such as blogs, social media, podcasts, etc. When working with the particular group or one-to-one correspondence, teacher can take advantage of web conferencing technologies and other online communication tool also. Now, it is also another important thing is the variety of learning styles. Every student has different learning journey and the different learning style. Some students are visual learners, while some students prefer to learn through audio. The online learning system, with its range of options, helps them to find resources. It can be personalized in many ways. It is also the best way to create perfect learning environment suited to the needs of each student. Now, the information mechanism. By the use of technology, students can find any answer to any question with a few clicks of the keys on the computer, on their smartphone also. The various powerful search engines of the computers can allow students to know organized knowledge, and simply they can find their answer also. But there are some disadvantages also. First of all, quality of information available in the online environment is sometimes questionable. Social scientists are raising voice against the negative effect of digital technology on different age groups at their individual or social level. Thirdly, the effect may vary from the lack of concentration, mental stability in case of mind of acute depression. There are other kinds of hazards like enormous amount of wastage of digital technology, declining writing skill, as well as lack of imaginative power in some cases. The cyber bullying trap are there. Online process of learning did not establish a direct link between the teacher and student relationship, and sometimes it is harmful for our health also. Now, network technologies and new educational methodologies have empowered learners, giving them a greater measure of control and participation in the learning process. It promoted education to cross boundaries, and a typical classroom setup in some educational system, which is previously drawn, is now broken down. But digital technology helps as a key factor for the scientific research and other investigation also. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. And now it is open for discussion. Dr. Iqbal again. Ma'am, do you think that this online teaching learning system should be continuing in place of classroom teaching after the COVID situation?
Yes, we can provide, in some colleges, they provide both offline and online services. And in our college also, teacher provide online services in classroom teaching, providing this term of teaching in our college. They came to our college and teach the online process. Some students who are came nearer, far nearer, they came to our college, and others with use of this online teaching, they can they learn their lessons also.
Okay, thank you. Next, Ms. Sharmani Banerjee. Sharmani, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Now share your screen and do not mere read out the slide, okay? And try to maintain the time limit of 6 minutes.
Okay, sir, okay. Is slide visible?
Yes, it is visible. Proceed.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Hi, good afternoon, everybody. I'm Sharmani Banerjee. Today's topic is e-learning experiences, apps and tools. Thanks to seminar organizers for giving me such an opportunity to share my experiences and views on this topic. Time is very short, and we already enriched us with the experts' details views about these topics. I just want to say that we all learning every day with our practical experiences. E-learning, according to me, is an easy, active, rational, neoteric, interactive, next generation, and gentle way of learning. And obviously, it is somehow different in some ways from online learning. Here in my presentation, I just explain the e-learning procedure in short with some basic question and answer. One second, please.
Go to next one.
Yeah, sir. Actually, the field of e-learning is very vast. This is a basic presentation to understand the meaning of e-learning in brief. Thank you. Thank you all for listening to me.
Have you completed?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Thank you. Is anybody there to for any clarification or suggestion? Okay. Then I would like to request Dr. Anish Soni. He is from Punjab.
Sir, am I audible?
Yeah, you are audible.
Thank you, sir. Screen is visible, sir?
Yes, it is visible.
Okay, nice. Good afternoon, all. Myself, Dr. Anish Soni from Akal Degree College, Maswana, Sangrur, Punjab. First of all, I would like to congratulate the whole team of BRNL College for organizing this wonderful workshop on a national platform. And I will thank Dr. Jaideep sir for sending us the invitation in a group which we created during a refresher course in Pondicherry. So my topic is importance of e-learning in higher education. Before starting this, and the major importance of e-learning is this workshop conference itself. All of we are going to a different part of our country. Maybe if e-learning or e-conference or these facilities are not available, then I cannot join this conference at any cost in the West Bengal from Punjab. But now it's very easy for all of us from different parts of country so that we can organize such type of conferences in which the different resource persons from different parts of the country are invited, and finally they are attending these kind of conferences. So what actually is the e-learning? All of us know very well, it is a process of extending the learning and delivering lectures to locations away from a classroom, building or site by using any video, audio, computer and multimedia communication like at this time we people are doing. Latest technologies like Cisco Webform, we are using, many other means are there, and using these types of means, electronics means, we can share, we can deliver the lecture far apart from our current locations. That holds a particular relevance to our India, as the youth constitutes its major population of our country is the youth, and it's due to lack of resources, basically, we cannot afford. So many people cannot afford the school learning, so many people cannot afford go for the higher education because of their poorness, because of lack of resources they have. But now for this e-learning, they can get the education, they can get upskills themselves at a very low cost, at sitting at their home, we can say parallelly with their job also. So many people in our country we know very well are not able to continue their education just because of they have to come into a job, they have to earn some. But now this using e-learning resources, they are able to get the skills, they are able what they want to get. So that is very much more important e-learning has in our India. So two types of e-learning there. Basically, one we called as the synchronous mean. Synchronous event takes place in real time. What real time is like at this particular time, what we are doing, that is a synchronous e-learning kind of. Means I am presenting something, all of you are listening, all of you are attending at a particular time. You have to sit for listening me. You have to attend for listening me. So that is a synchronous kind of e-learning. For example, audio video conference, we are doing at this particular time. Another means of e-learning is the asynchronous, in which there is no foundation of presenting at a particular time, at a real time. Like online courses are there. So many online courses are there. Student can choose any course of his choice and he can learn, he do that course at any time. No foundation is there ki whether he has to attend this course in the day, whether he has to attend this course in the evening, or whether he has to attend this course in the night. Whenever he felt he is free, whenever he felt he is comfortable, he can join the course, he can learn the skills at its own pace also. So many people, while delivering the online lectures, while delivering the offline lectures in our classes also, there is a big disadvantage what I feel over the last few years, ki all students are not of equal pace. Like I am presenting something to the students, so many of can get at the first moment I told about that, but so many are also there who cannot take it this way, so I have to repeat it again. But for the shyness, students are even not answering, some not even not questioning, they take it as it is I delivered. But in case e-learning, they can show the videos again and again, they can so the lectures again and again, they can listen to it carefully, whatever time they required. So that kind of listening, that kind of e-learning is the asynchronous learning. So these two types of e-learning are there. So next question is, why e-learning? E-learning type target audience by engaging learners who have been attending the convenient classroom training because of they may be geographically dispersed with the limited time and or resources to travel. They don't have the resources to travel and have very limited time. They may be busy with work or their family commitments which do not allow them to attend the courses. As I already told you, so many people in India are there who have to earn the money, who have to take care of their family. So they cannot attend the regular classes, they cannot attend the regular colleges. For them, this is a, you can say, blessing. E-learning is a blessing for them. Maybe post-conflict areas and mobility, they cannot move to any another area, some for the security reasons. Like for example, if I like some areas in the Kashmir which are very dangerous point of, you can say, they people cannot travel to the Haryana or the Punjab or Delhi itself for attending these type of conferences. But due to this e-learning, they at their own place can attend the conferences. Limited from the participating in classroom sessions because of cultural or religious belief. And another reason, they may be facing difficult with the real-time communication. For example, foreign language learners or very shy learners, are I already told you. Importance of e-learning in higher education. So many importance, so many advantages and disadvantages, some people already told you in the previous half hour. So that is all the common. We all know very well the importance of e-learning, but with the different perspective, I will show you that is a greater access. One of the biggest advantage of e-learning in higher education is that it transcends the geographical boundaries. No geographical boundaries are there. It always allows students to benefit of a class irrespective of their physical location. Resource scalability is there. Now e-learning enables the institutes to save a great amount of time and money. They don't have to incur any form of expenditures, hiring instructor, purchasing equipment, other resources. Instead, they can use these saved up resources to improve the quality of overall learning process. Better result. E-learning in higher education have been improved productivity. Although that is very clear ki it cannot be an alternative to the offline learning, but during pandemic situation like COVID-19, we have realized that these type of learnings must be there, but we have to use the blended mode. The major part we have to use the blended mode, because only e-learning is not sufficient for the students. They can learn online at their home, but all the emotional and motivational growth they have in their colleges, they have in schools, that cannot be at their home. School and colleges are not only for the learning purposes, that are also for the students, or their emotional and motivational growths are there, you know. So they have to go to the school and colleges. It cannot be an alternative to that. But if we use blended mode, means open and online mode, then it can be a better solution for the students. And it results in the better results also, because if a student something studied in the school and colleges, and it also has some e-resources related to that, which he can follow, or he can again and again it at their home also. Even my lecture is going on in the classroom. Maybe students at that time, student as much as mine, what we can do, we can capture that lecture so that students can have it in their home and can show that lecture again and again. And that results in the better results of the students. As per research, students boost their results by 25% to 60% through the e-learning. Improved pace, I already told you, different students have different pace of learning. Learning doesn't restrict any student. Every student can learn at their own pace. Cost effectiveness is there, as already madam also told, that student has no need any physical books, they need not to travel, accommodations, hostels and all, whatever. All these expenditure can be, you can say, minimized. That is the cost effectiveness of e-learning. Quick lesson delivery compared to traditional method is much more sophisticated. See, most e-learning lessons are wrapped up with a single academic session, so the students are given the flexibility to extend or reduce their session time depending upon their needs and requirements. Similarly, personalization. E-learning in higher education doesn't usually take place in group setting. Instead, it imparts education in more personalized and specific, transparent way. Student can choose to ask questions. Already, we all of us must be listen about MOOCs. If you use the MOOCs platform, then that personalization is better than in offline. Students can ask the question, it can leave the feedback also, it can leave the responses also, student can seek the repetitions, and student can clarify the doubts also as per their own level of comprehension. Instant upskilling, students can upgrade itself, even not students, even ourselves also. We are the educators, we are the teachers, but we are not bound to the syllabus of any university. You are not bound to the syllabus given by our institute, ki you have to just deliver this syllabus to the student. If we have to cope up with the market, then we have to upskill ourselves also. And for at least teachers, that instant upskilling is the e-learning. We cannot now join any college, we cannot now join any company to upgrade our skills. So that upskilling is better by using this e-learning. We can choose any course. So many courses are there on the website, different website, different Udemy you must be learned now, Swam you must be learned about. So many courses are there which even we people can join to upgrade ourselves. Traceable outcomes are there. Last but not the least, e-learning works wonder when it comes to getting outcomes, tracing results and gathering feedback. While it is not possible to keep a close tab on every student, e-learning method ensures that a continuous and consistent evaluation can be undertaken to assess the regular progress. As a result, the needs of every student are accommodated and quality of learning becomes better. So, to conclude myself, e-learning does not only provide the learning objective, but it also evaluates the progress of students. It is naturally suited to distance learning and flexible learning. You can say With the merged social networking, blogging and YouTube, students expected to be able to utilize modern technology on the fly to connect everything. Thank you very much. These are the references I have followed this paper. Thank you very much. Any queries?
Thank you, Dr. Anish. Yes, one thing is correct that the e-learning mode has widened out the geographic barrier. So that we can communicate with each other beyond our geographic location. Yes. Sir, there is any demerits of e-learning in higher education among the new generation students in social aspect. Another question is, Dr. Shoni, my observation is that in our country, very little percentage of students can afford to have the internet access. Rightly said, Dr. Ganguly, my senior Didi, Indiradi. Yes, Indiradi, actually, Dr. Banerjee has also focused on the digital divide of our country, but hopefully we'll wipe it out, and definitely in some near future, we'll get better access and the issues will be sorted out. And now, is Mr. Prosenjit Pramanik there? I think Prosenjit is not there. So may I request Ms. Payal Sarkar and Dr. Shopon Khan to present their
paper. Thank you, sir. Thank you all.
Dr. Khan? Dr. Khan, are you there? So I would like to request the next one. Yes, ma'am.
I'm Sonali Dabshi, I'm present.
Okay. Wait for your turn, Dr. Dabshi. I think it is a turn of Dr. Asif Iqbal. Dr. Iqbal?
Yes.
Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Let's start. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Am I audible?
I have to share the screen. Okay, let's start.
You are visible.
Now it is. Now is it visible?
The sharing is starting. It's showing the starting to share the content.
Okay, I think this is slow due to slow network. Is it visible?
Still, yet not.
The screen. I have to click on screen one. Okay. Now?
Now it is visible.
Visible? Okay.
It is visible, sir.
Okay, okay. Good afternoon. Good afternoon, all. I'm MD Asif Iqbal, Assistant Professor in Mathematics from Khatra Adivasi Mahavidyalaya, Bakura. Okay. First of all, I'd like to thank to the organizers and the chairperson of this session for giving me the opportunity to say something about my topics, that is e-learning development for undergraduate mathematics. Actually, before this pandemic situation, I know very little about this Google Meet, Zoom, e-content, e-module, MOOCs like this. And in this period, I have completed two or more training courses, one of which from Pondicherry University. I have learned a lot from this, and from that knowledge, I'm sharing my slides. And the slides, I'm trying to develop the e-content for undergraduate mathematics. Now, what is e-content? All you know that e-content, this is a paperless documents, which includes, there's a PDF of the text content, there's some videos, some PowerPoints, some audio, etc. And I know, all you know that, why e-content? The e-content for joyful and complete learning, which is termed as e-learning. And e-learning also enables us to learn anywhere and anytime, all you know that. The e-content is also a powerful tool for encouraging students for self-learning also. And that is another advantage of this e-learning is that anyone can easily carry these e-content modules into weightless devices like pen drives, CD, DVD, etc. Now, e-content for undergraduate mathematics. The e-learning is the teaching of mathematics is very important issues nowadays to motivate our students, particularly in mathematics education, to remove the mathematics phobia among these students. And the students through e-learning, studying mathematics through e-learning and using the e-content module by using some software, tools, etc., may also be a supplement of the traditional textbooks also, learning also. There are so many geometrical shapes, particularly in mathematics, in geometrical shapes, particularly in three-dimensional figures, we cannot plot it in our textbook, in our notebook. So at that time, we can help the tools and techniques to draw the pictures, to understand the pictures also. There are several learning resources we know as text-based learning resources, like lectures and pre-recorded lectures, videos, web-based learning, and e-content online also. These are the top mathematics e-learning softwares for undergraduate courses, especially for undergraduate courses on higher. There's all of them are not free and open. First of all, I said about the Origin plotter. Origin is a powerful plotter. This is the YouTube link. This is the link of these softwares. You can download this from this. But this software is not free. It is free up to some extent. So this is a powerful plotter, 2D and 3D mathematical graph plotter. GNUplotter is also a very good plotter. Actually, it's free and open, and it is a LaTeX-based, it was previously LaTeX-based, but now it is available in our Windows system also. And GNUplotter is also a very good plotter for various mathematical equation figures also. Desmos like this, this is also a plotter. GeoGebra, this is the tools. This plots algebra, geometry, spreadsheets, graphs, statistics, and analysis calculus also. This is free and open software in our nets. X function and maxima is also helps us in solving algebraic, numeric, calculus related problems over the computer. These two are also free softwares. We can download this software anytime and use this software to prepare the e-content module for our online class, for our online classroom, and also offline classroom also. There are another math solver softwares that is delivers elaborate information about the graphs. These Microsoft based softwares and Saga Maths and Ulfra Mathematica and MATLAB. All we know about this Mathematica and MATLAB. They are the programming based software, and this software is not free, but it is all not free, but it helps us a lot. Not only for undergraduate mathematics, it also helps to our researchers also. And last one, there's a LaTeX software. It's an editing software. It is a Linux based software, but now it is available. There are so many editors in Windows system also. You can use the LaTeX software for preparing the documents. Now, how can we prepare our e-content module? We can use these tools. That is, Dr. Kushami previously told elaborately about the OBS Studio. Audio Studio is a very good software, very powerful software for screen recording and live streaming. Dr. Kupuswamy told briefly about this merits and demerits of this software. So we can use this Audio Studio to prepare our e-content module like screen recording and live streaming. OpenShot and Bondicam is like the same software like Audio Studio. And if we want to edit this video after recording, then we can use the Video Studio OpenShot software to edit this video if you wish to edit this software after recording. And the Beamer is also a software. It is a free software, LaTeX-based software for preparing the PowerPoint presentation like this. We can prepare the PowerPoint for PowerPoint, Microsoft PowerPoint, but without, we can use also Beamer software to prepare the PowerPoint by using this software. Beamer is also free, absolutely free software. Now, these are some steps to prepare the screen capture video by its own efforts. First, you have to prepare a PowerPoint content. Now you download the OBS Studio software in your desktop computer, open your PowerPoint slides and minimize this in your computer. Now start OBS Studio recording by using your phone camera and show the PowerPoint slide as you deliver lectures. Stop recording and deliver your lecture after delivering lecture. Now the file is automatically saved in the OBS Studio. This is a procedure to prepare a content through OBS Studio. And if you want to edit this software after recording, you can use the video audio software. Actually, I have prepared a video. I just saw 1 or 2 minutes how it look like. This is the software. This is screen capture video. I prepared it. Your feature is in the top side.
First, but it was Leibniz.
So you can prepare this software by your own effort.
Now, you
need to help any others.
We have to know first for the slope. The rate at which a line rises or falls is called the slope. For a line, the rate is same at every point on the line, and for a graph other than line, the rate at which the graph
so rises. The time is very short, we cannot show it full PDF.
And I have to determine the rate at which the graph rises or falls.
Thank you. So anyone can prepare this software by using this OBS Studio and Canvaster. And these are the YouTube links to prepare how to make lesson videos in career coding, how to teach mathematics in OneNote, how to animate equation in PowerPoint, how to record computer screen, how to type math equation in MS Word, how to create e-content by mobile phone. There are so many YouTube links. You can use these YouTube links and prepare the e-content for our students anytime, anywhere. And lastly, I want to conclude my conclusion that though we have sometimes faced different technological issues to prepare and teach through e-content, but I think as a mathematics teacher, this is the right time to look forward. I also emphasize to say that teaching mathematics with e-content should be started from elementary level so that learner can be adopted with this system very early. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Asifda.
Thank you.
Actually, one thing I must say that the refresher course of Pondicherry University, from where me, you, and Dr. Anish
yes
have participated, and as well as we have learned something from Professor Kupuswamy there.
Yes.
I think the video you have shared, it is from the micro-teaching PPT.
Yes. Not only micro-teaching, it's the micro-teaching PPT. Yes. Yes, Rajiv.
Okay.
We are very much grateful to Pondicherry University for preparing this.
Exactly. The course was wonderful.
Wonderful courses. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you once again to you, especially to you for your great efforts to arrange this national seminar.
Okay. Now, Payal has messaged that she has some network issue. So, may we allow Payal or Abhijitda, you will continue? Abhijitda.
First.
Dr. Abhijit Dutta. May we allow Payal or you are ready?
Yeah, I have to stop this.
Abhijit da, are you there? Dr. Abhijit Datta.
Sir, I'm here.
This is Swanjita, madam.
Yes, sir. I'm sorry.
Isn't?
Yes, sir.
Ma'am, can we allow Payal Sarkar? Or after you?
Sir, it's up to you.
Are you ready or may we allow
Yes, I'm ready.
Ms. Payal Sarkar?
Sir, I'm ready, but...
Due to some... No, no, it's up to you because it's your turn.
What to say?
Okay, then you continue. Then I will request Payal to present after you.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir, kindly please share my slides. Am I audible, sir?
Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. You are audible.
Sir, can you please share my slides?
Okay. Just allow me a few minutes.
Okay, sir.
Is it visible?
Yes, sir, it's visible. Sir, may I start?
Yeah, proceed.
Okay, sir. Good afternoon, everybody. Our topic of presentation is Google in imparting education beyond face-to-face mode. Present century is very much technology dependent, and this technology has played an immense role in the sphere of educational sector, which has even revolutionized our traditional mode of teaching learning process. Education beyond face to face is not simply an assemblage of words understandable only by a few, but in the present situation, it has become a part and parcel of everybody's life. And in this regard, the role of Google is noteworthy. It plays the role of a panacea for e-education system. Next slide, please. The major objectives of the study are to examine the role of Google Apps and tools in imparting education beyond the traditional classroom. Secondly, to identify the various purposes of using the same, as well as to determine the various limitations in using such tools along with their probable solutions. Next slide, please. The major tools used in this study are Google Classroom, Google Meet, Gmail, Google Drive, Google Form, Google Calendar, Google Sites, YouTube. Next slide, please. Role of Google tools in imparting education. Google tools have, since its inception, Google has become the world's largest and most noted search engine site. First of all, it plays immense role in preserving sharing of documents. Besides this, any type of file format can be viewed through the various Google apps. Another noted thing is that through Google Meet, we can share our screen while delivering any kind of informations. Calling facility is another noted aspect. Through it, one can have the ability to call into meetings using a dial-in number in the US. It is an added feature of it. Besides this, Google Drive helps even in scanning of documents. Google Form is another noted aspect which helps us a lot in the smooth completion of the evaluation process. Another noted thing is that the background, in order to maintain the concentration during any kind of meeting, we can change the background features. Several external web applications work with Google Drive available from the Chrome web stores. This is the third party apps. Next, Google provides the students to explore the wide range of information. That is, it helps in empowering the students because it provides wide range of information available irrespective of age, socioeconomic status, gender, anything. Means it has crossed all boundaries. Google provides a wide range of choice for both educators and students. Next slide, please. Limitations. In spite of all this, there are several limitations. First of all is limited entry. It has implied restrictions in the entry to its meet. Next feature is that the feature of recording. It is only available for the paid versions. Those who are using the unpaid versions, for them it is not available. During any kind of meeting, there is a problem of display of drop-down menus. Next, Google Classroom is not effective where bandwidth is low. It is a common issue. Next, in case of Google problem, Google Form, another major problem is that of the settings issue. It largely influences the entire process of evaluation. Even minute mistakes disrupts the privacy of the entire services. Next, sign-in is another problem. Attaching, uploading, and sending documents through mail also creates, there are issues occurs owing to uploading, sending, attachment through Gmail. Probable solutions. To overcome all these limitations, the most noted solution is Google Workspace for Education, that is the formerly G Suite. It is the paid version. It has added many features, and the new features includes for Google Classroom through offline mode, one can access all the documents, improved mobile grading, classroom add-ons, and better pictures and homeworks. Next, it helps will launch student engagement tracking inside the classroom. For Google Meet, multiple moderators will be there. End meeting for all. Teachers will have the option to end meeting for all, even mute also everybody at a whole. As a whole, we can conclude that technological influence has created immense impact on the educational system, which has crossed all boundaries. This has reduced the geographical distance, which matters the most. And Google, in this regard, plays a dominating role in imparting education beyond the face-to-face mode. It is a platform which is extremely useful in assignment and collaborating learning, which on the other hand facilitates the development, research, as well as the entire teaching learning process. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for your nice presentation.
Thank you, sir.
There must be some questions. No question yet. Is there any query or suggestion or any experience? Because many of us are using G Suite. So if you want to suggest something or okay. Next, may I request Ms. Payal Sharkar?
Yes, sir. Am I audible, sir?
Yes, you are audible.
Sir, can you please share my slide?
Wait for a minute, please.
Okay, sir.
Is it visible?
Yes, sir. It is visible. Can I start now, sir?
Yeah, start.
Okay, thank you so much. Hi, this is Payal Sharkar. I'm sharing my thoughts with you through the conference on e-learning tools and technology study in COVID-19. The next slide, please. The next one, sir. Yes, that is, we all know what is COVID-19. It is world pandemic now. That's why many countries have decided to close school, college, and university. For that, many institutions to repeatedly implement alternative education and assignment strategies. And what is virtual education? And we all know about the virtual education, that is where teacher Payal, and student is paid.
Payal, yes, sir. Sorry for interruption. Can you sound a little bit? Your
Hello?
Voice is coming very low.
Is it okay, sir?
Is it okay? Fine.
Okay, thank you, sir. Okay, what is virtual education? We all know that where teacher and student are separate time and space, and education concept provides through management application and internet etc. That is the most remarkable invention of this age, the best alternative of traditional education. The next slide, please. That is objective of the study, to show present condition of education, ways to know about the tools and technology of e-education, to show advantage and some challenges of it. So next slide. Some e-learning apps are there, that is Google Classroom, Google Docs, Google Slide, and Google Classroom is a powerful and easy to use wave app. We all know that, and some are there. The next slide, that is Socrative, Emodo, Scratch, PZ, and there is some more. That's sir. We all know that's is Kahoot, Emodo, Scratch, PZ. So next slide, please. All right. So Google Drive, Nearpad, Kahoot, Zoom Education, and Zoom Education is the best cloud video conference web app that assists you sharing your thought. And there's some more platform is Class Dojo, Webex, Cisco, YouTube. We all about is it is the best way, the e-learning app, and some advantages of there. The next slide, and then next, sir. Right. Some advantages are there, that is e-learning content development to learn foreign language, easy to use, it is more flexible, easy build a demo in class, time saving for user, mirror presentation between teacher and student, it can increase to green evolution, and increasing using app, it's benefited into it industries. So next slide, that is some challenges are there, that is technical default, and some which I faced before some time, that is technical issue and network issue. That is the biggest issue of e-challenges, e-learning, and some issues there, cost effectiveness, social and cultural barriers are there, IT obstacle, user frustration, all negative point are there. And I conclude with the modern advancements of the next slide, right? Modern advancement in technology have transmitted in education process. Therefore, it implement for learning and teaching adopt them. The conventional teaching used education is shifting to student-focused education, which facilitated the learning to manage their own education. But it is mostly acceptable at present developing country, not in developing country. We all countries should welcome object-oriented home-based learning tools. And it's time to say thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. Is any question? Dr. Niloy Kaur Chaudhary, I think, asked for is Google Drive. I think it is for Shonchita ma'am, that He is asking that whether the Google Drive is, can we use Google Drive for scanning purpose?
Yes, sir. It can be done through, if you use an Android phone, if you go to Google Drive, then you will get that option in the below, in the, at the below of the screen. From there, you can scan documents.
Okay, thank you. Any other question? Okay, so may I request Dr. Sonali Dapse to present her presentation.
May I audible?
Yes, ma'am, you are audible. You are visible too.
Yes, my topic is plagiarism software. Actually, I am focused the open access software, open access plagiarism software. Actually, the modern technology and development of internet have to give access of huge information. So original ideas of trends become too rare to rare. Everything to seems product their people of idea and presenting them as their own. Although this practice not anything new, so it will show the necessity the checking of plagiarism. Most of the popular software which is available of the internet, Urkund, is the university to provide. So actually the all of the people cannot access the Urkund. So the some open source plagiarism software, we are checking some our works and show this paper has been discussed the free and open plagiarism software. Here the modern technology's age, this plagiarism is the use of the original words or idea have sent the own or any time anyone can borrow from the original sources, is to commit the literary theft, is to present the new or original product, is to use without the creating of the sources. And next, the one of the types, most types of the plagiarism is the open source plagiarism and commercial plagiarism. The source code, some two types of plagiarism, the with some sources are not to cited, the ghostwriter, the photocopy, the potluck paper, the code distinguish, or the laborers or self shelter, and some are cited to plagiarized. Is the forgotten footnote or anti plagiarism some perfect time, some resourceful citer is the cited plagiarized. So the modes of plagiarized checker is to two types. Only the online plagiarism checker, which is available of the internet, and which is the plagiarism software in bond or purchase of any commercial platform, so to check their works. Plagiarism checking reports after 10 and present duplication, actually 10% of the actual work is to plagiarize, is not a plagiarism, or more than 10%. We are seeking, or we are to imagine this is the plagiarized, and then open source plagiarism software are to the plag scan, doubly checker, plag checker, copy leaker, doubly checker, plagiarisma, paper letter. So some softwares are we can access and audit for trial based. Some works are to checking there. And some software are not to download there, but some are all are download the open source, but it is most of them the trial based. So commercial software, Authenticate or Urkund. Urkund is the most popular. I previously told it is available on the university, which is provide the InfliNet. So many people cannot access them. Their own work we can access or send any works of the seminar or any other platform, we can check the open source software, plagiarism software. And it is the plagiarism software dictation tools, is that tools name extralink, intralink, source codes are user friendly. It is also the user friendly. It is source code is available open source plagiarism software. So I have two different plagiarism software to test it, plag scan. We have been seen that some red lines are plagiarism. So some software we have checked, but doobly checker, plag leaker, copy leaker, paper rater, and so we have seen that the plagiarism is the appropriate icon of the authors to check their own works or different plagiarism software are available of the same paper checking of every software, but percentage of the plagiarism is different. So we have found the plag scan and the comparisons of different open source software. We have found the plag scan or paper rater is the most accurate of them. So I remind that the open source software is the most popular of the plagiarism platform. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Is there anybody? I think Indira Di should ask few questions on plagiarism.
Yes.
No, I think she is not here. Okay, anyway, thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
May I request Mr. Sujan Bandhu Bhattacharya to share his presentation? Okay.
Yes, sir. Can you start, sir?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. I hope the screen is visible, sir.
Yeah, it is visible.
Okay, thank you. My or our topic is role of institutional repositories in e-learning, a study of eGAN course of IGNU. We all know, in fact, IGNU, but we don't, we all don't know about the eGAN course facilities provided by IGNU. To start, let me introduce the institutional repository at a very basic information. It's kind of a digital archive for the intellectual properties of an institution. It's a digital repository of all the educational documents. Maybe it's course material, learning objects. It's indicator for the the researches and the documents prepared by the for the learning purposes for the students is definitely an indicator for that. And as you see that Clifford Lynch, executive director of Coalition for Network Information, stated that a university-based IR is a set of services that a university offers to the members of its community for the management and dissemination of digital materials. That means the digital materials prepared by the to support learning heard of that particular institutions of the university. IR or the institutional repository support all the teaching learning methods by providing the facility to access the digital materials through a very simple and easy process. These are the basic components of the IR. I have listed few of them. What the content should be in the IR. It may be preprints, maybe postprints, articles, research reports, and the most important thing is the second one is learning object. Because learning object can be the e-learning materials. Learning object can be the educational materials for the course materials. It may be the practical part of that particular course also. Practical part, virtual mode. Content management through IR IR staffing means to manage the IR, there should be a dedicated persons to manage that particular IR system. There are some costs involved in that particular IR. In the next point, I have mentioned the softwares that can be used for the for installation of IR. Cprint, Fedora, Greenstone, several are there, but among them, DSpace is definitely the major one. And to install DSpace or to maintain DSpace, there are some costs involved, but that can be, that is negligible, because DSpace is a open source software. If you have the staff already in your institution, then they can manage that software easily without involving additional costs. And other components are the policies, metadata settings, Romeo, Sherpa, etc. are there. And how IR facilitate e-learning for the students or for the students is being an influential force in the as we all have through phase of down, and we have already experienced the benefits of the e-learning, because at home we can access the course materials uploaded by the university or the institutions. Those who are using this kind of facilities. And I think all the educational institutions should use these kinds of facilities to facilitate their students, even during the pandemic situation or any adverse situation. And to facilitate the students through their e-learning system, learning objects is the most important component. And this is also more the IR. And the main goals of the ALO are to help teachers and learners to acquire and develop competence, skill, ability to create knowledge base and to learn how to create knowledge based products. ALO repositories or LOR are basic infrastructure for digital and web-based learning environment. It's a one window approach, because from that particular window, you'll get all the learning materials, may it be a theoretical part or the practical part, whatever. To the EGAN of IGNU, the Central Open University of India, and EGANCUS is the centralized institutional repository of IGNU. For 4 million students present, they created this large materials for them inside that the IE course is type is already said that languages are there, the English and Hindi subject, definitely multidisciplinary. More than 15,000 views per day they are getting right now, and more than 15 lakh documents they have already uploaded there. Documents means course materials. And what are the course materials are there? If I go through the site of EGANCOS, that is egancos.ac.in, I can see the communities they have created with self-learning materials. SWAM courses are there, very important, and also the YouTube videos. And along with that, some Facebook live recorded videos are there. They have created the sub-communities with the, if I go through the next, these are the sub-communities with the, one second, yeah. The sub-communities they have created with the schools of their university, like humanities, social science, education, computer education, etc. And that more than 2400 YouTube videos for the learners of all levels, and 100 Facebook videos for all the learners they have, and 40,000 self-learning materials are there for certificate UG, PG learners. Now think, if these are not available for the student, 4 million students of the university, then what will be the effect of the lockdown? Because if they have if they don't have the facility of e-learning or the e-course materials provided right now by the IGNU, there would be a great problem for the learners to get the materials and get them educated, or get them, I mean, scoring marks in the exam. If we, the matter of scoring marks in the exam, anyone, and as this is an open access repository and the learning objects are also there, so if anyone do not then that is possible through this IER, because it is completely open access, anyone access from anywhere at any time. So it's an impact in the facility provided by IGNU to the students through eGAN Coach. To get the course, you find communities. There are some communities depending on schools and departments. That's like you can go to the UG courses, PG courses, certificate courses. Then you can also find the old course, old materials along with the current one. Now go to the year-based question papers, everything in a very structured way and organized form. I have just put an example over here to, I mean, in that particular block one, information, nature, properties, and scope, we'll find that PDF file with the course content, and all the materials are there to study. So you can go through all these things and study at your own pace and time, sitting at your home, maybe at your workplace also. So I think the whole thing has been done by simply creating an institutional repository, that is eGAN Coach. And any institution with staff and resources can be can be able to do this by just installing an institutional software and uploading documents time to time to facilitate their students. I mean, educational resources are not only a boon to the registered learners, but it is a facility that be beneficial for the prospect. Don't want to enroll to a course, but on a particular subject. Maybe it's department they are belonged, but they want to learn the subject from another department. Because of IGNU is one of the best examples for how it is provided through the use of IERS. IGAN Coach brought tremendous benefit to engaging and sharing its e-learning resources. And this central online repository can be a highly effective part of the university's management strategy. So that's it from my part. Thank you, if any question are there.
Thank you, Sujan. Sujan is very dynamic librarian of Brainerd University. May I request Mr. Sumit Kumar Mukherjee, that sir, you have asked a question that how the librarian can share the information, or the as a librarian, how can we provide support during the lockdown period? I think Sujan has mentioned, and beside that, I would like to share that there are plenty of resources you may opt for NDLI, National Digital Library of India.
Yes, sir.
And different open access resources are there, Creative Commons license resources are there, and different librarians all over the country has arranged different workshop or seminars during the lockdown period. So that must be a good output from the librarian fraternity. And I think it may be the way how we can support our client.
Yes, sir. And I have just gone through a few of the presentations made here. They have mentioned Google Drive, Google Classroom. I mean, these are very, very beneficial for the students, or even for the teachers also, to to use that particular software, or maybe the application, to provide the e-learning resources or e-learning materials, or even taking. Because in our university, we are doing this last 11 months. So there is no other way to, I mean, provide classes to the students other than going online.
Actually, you make me nostalgic because the IGNU study material from eGAN Coach, I have used it for last 20 years. during my student period. So it is a very good resources even for today for cracking the net set.
Absolutely, sir. Absolutely. Even I have gone through all the materials to crack the net.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
So may I request Dr. A.J. Jain?
Yes, sir. Are you able to hear me, sir?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I'm sharing my screen.
Okay.
Is it visible, sir?
It is. Yeah, it is visible. And he is from Tamil Nadu. So let's start. So,
everybody. So I'm Sanmadi Jain, working as semi-professional assistant library at the Central University of Tamil Nadu, Tiruvarur. So you know, my topic will be on Wakelet, which is a content curation tool. So I will be talking about the application of Wakelet for online teaching and learning. So first thing is regarding Wakelet. Wakelet is a free platform, you know, which allows you to create and organize content and share with the students. So you know, Wakelet is kind of it's a free tool. You can save various kinds of content, and you can share it in a single platform. So you can save videos, articles, images, links, bookmarks, tweets, text, etc. And you can organize all those into a collection, and you can share it with the students. So you know, the steps to create a Wakelet collection is to choose a content, which is a text content or a PDF or a video or image, and add all those contents into your collection and share those via social networks. I will be sharing you all the step by step screenshots to how to create a Wakelet collection. So the first step is login into Wakelet, wakelet.com, and login. There is an option called login at the top. You can log in using your Gmail ID. After logging in, there will be an option called create a new collection. So you just click create a new collection, and then you will be seeing this picture. So here you can you can enter your title of your collection. You can for example, for any paper, like I'll be showing an example of a paper here, a paper, for example, information systems and services, for which semester the course code I have given here. So I'll be sharing, I'll be putting all the contents for the students. I'll be uploading all the contents here. Here you, at the down, you'll be seeing a plus symbol where you can add all the contents. So if you see, you'll be having numerous options like paste URL, add text, add UK, you can add YouTube video, you can add a tweet link, you can add a bookmark, image, you can upload a PDF, you can upload even an ebook which you have in your Google Drive, you can share that Google Drive link and OneDrive. So you have all kinds of facilities here. You can add different types of content and for a particular course, and you can share it with the students. So it is a very it is a free platform. It is an open access tool. It is a very beneficial for teaching as well as learning. In Central University of Tamil Nadu, most of the faculties have been using this tool, and I got positive feedback regarding this tool. So I thought of putting a paper in this topic. There is an option for sharing, for who can view your collection, the access. So if you want to publish your content public, you can put public. If you want only very selective people, you are only the students of your class to see the collection, you can list out. You can select unlisted, and there is also option for private. Only you can see the collection. So after choosing all the contents, you can the next step is to share with the students. So how to share? There is an arrow mark which I've made here. You can click the arrow mark, and you can in the form of link, you can copy this link, wke.io. Can share this link with the students. You can embed this link into a Google Classroom or MS Teams, the LMS you have been using, and you can also export this as a PDF. You can, if you click the export as PDF, all the content will will come into a PDF sheet, and you can share those sheet with the students, and the students can just click the sheet whichever content they can access everything. So you know it will look like this. See, for the paper for information systems and services for semester 1, the course code, you know, I have given the textual content here, you know, the objectives and the learning outcomes in the text content, the PDF file. I've shared a PDF file of those, a Google Drive link, you know, I've downloaded an ebook and I've saved into my Google Drive. I've shared Google Drive link here, and you know, you can give an URL link of any website useful, you know, a web resource. You can embed a YouTube video here, you know, you can embed an image also, image file. So you know, students can access a variety of content, you know, text, PDF, whichever they like. You can access a variety of content for a single topic, so it will be very useful for them to learn, and it is very, you know, very much easier for even the for the faculty, so that you know they can teach, you know, and they can share the share their e-content in various across, you know, different kinds of formats. So the key features, you know, they can collaborate, even, you know, faculties, they can collaborate within each other, they can also assign some group projects or assignments through this one, you know, they can copy this collection again and again, and you know, Wakelet can be translated into different languages also, not only in English. It has you know, features of various languages. You can embed your collection, Wakelet collection, into, you can embed in your website, you know, library website, or your, you know, your college library or university website. You can embed into inside a blog, and also in your LMS like Google Classroom or Moodle, which I've been using in your institution. And it is also available as a mobile app. So mobile app facility is also available, so that students can, you know, within a single click, they can access their content in using their mobile app. There is, you know, a browser extension facility is also available. So to conclude with, you know, faculties can capture all the learning and teaching content that they find online. They can, you know, anything like the text, PDF, video, article, podcast, videos, anything, you know, they can share it with their class students using Wakelet, which is a very curatable platform and easier to access for the students. And now, if you want to learn about Wakelet, you can check in YouTube as well as, you know, wakelet.com, so that you you will learn more about Wakelet and you can use it in your institution. And at the outset, I would like to thank VSR College for giving me this opportunity to share my presentation. Any questions, sir? I'd be happy to answer.
Yes. Is anybody there? Okay. May I request Dr. Pranavi Podal to present her presentation?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Just a minute. Is it visible, sir?
Yes, it is visible. Proceed, please.
This is my topic, online educational tools and techniques, the role of libraries in this present era. Varieties of online tools are available to meet the varieties of demand for online education. It is very crucial to select the appropriate tools for different stakeholders of online educational system, like teachers, students, authorities, and so on. Those are the objectives of our study: to identify the online teaching learning educational tool, to analyze those tools for different educational institution, to state the alternative possibilities of online education, to find the role of libraries in different aspect of online education. Those are the online teaching learning method, CML versus CML is the computer managed learning system, and CAL computer assist learning. Next, the synchronous versus asynchronous, individual versus collaborative learning, and fixed versus adaptive e-learning. The main role of computer is recorded keeping, and it is not provided any direct instruction to the learner. Computer CAL use computers together with traditional teaching. This method uses a combination of multimedia such as text, graphics, sound, and videos. Synchronous is a real interaction with other people at the same time and same place or same online environment. In asynchronous learning, it is not real-time interaction. It is not engaged in the learning process at the same time. Individual versus collaborative learning. Individual learning has been norm in a traditional classroom for thousands of years. It refers to the number of students participating in arriving the learning goals rather than student centeredness of the material. In collaborative learning, it describes synchronously and interactively a joint solution to some problem, and it emphasizes on the extent and qualities of exchanges that occurred within group of students in a collaborative environment. In fixed learning, the content used during the learning process does not change from its original state, and all participating students receive the same information as all the others. Whereas adaptive e-learning, it is the possibility to adopt and redesign learning materials for each individual learner on the basis of the student performance, goals, abilities, skills, etc. Those are the main online tools and techniques. The communication tools such as Google Meet, Zoom, social media such as WhatsApp, Facebook, online whiteboard such as Jamboard, whiteboard, document management tool, Google Drive, Dropbox, work planning tools, Google Calendar, Outlook Calendar, learning management system such as Moodle, Mindfreeze. This is the role of libraries, that the identification of online tools and selection of those are recommend which tools are most important to the specific user for the recommendation. And next, the evaluation. These are the online learning method. Flowchart. This is the flowchart for learning methods and online tools. On the based of the the selection of the best alternatives, then recommended to the stakeholders such as students, which was best for this for the student, which was the best for the particular teachers or the authorities also. This is the activities of the librarian in this way, such as terms of availability of the tools, user friendliness, or the minimum complexity, free or paid version, pros and cons of those online tools, contact online vendors, and assist to the procure the tools. Prepare list of tools according to their popularity, helping to store educational information systematically, inform the free sources of books, journal, security, privacy, confidentiality related issues, and the continuing update of the library website, and so on. This is the conclusion of our studies. To enhance the online teaching learning method, librarians can play a significant role with their expertise and knowledge. And this can be achieved by taking a branch of online activities for learners, teachers, and administrators. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. So the forum is open for any discussion or recommendation for Dr. Poodle.
Yes, sir.
Now I am asking for the other participant that if there are any suggestion or question to you. If not, then I will call the next one. The next one is very interesting. The next one is from Jammu, Mr. Sahil Bains. The Jammu people, including Sahil and Dr. Meghna Dhar, both are from Jammu University, are facing some network issues. So Sahil has sent me his video presentation. So I'm trying to present the presentation. It is for 5 minutes. Just go through it. Is it visible?
I am Sahil. The title of the study is User Perception of OpenSSL Sources and the Application in Online Learning Environment, a Case Study. My presentation is divided into certain contents. It has introduction, objectives, research methodology, findings, and conclusion. Talking about the introduction, OpenSSL sources are those sources that are available online, free of cost in digital format, and are not bound to most of the licensing and copyright issues. The different OpenSSL sources include ebooks, ETCs, e-journals, repositories, search engines, etc. These are available over the internet and most of them are freely accessible. They can be put to immediate use, which is time of the person looking to satisfy his or her needs. Objectives. The study is carried out with following objectives in mind: to find out the awareness of using OpenSSL sources among the students, what is the preferred place of using them, the reasons behind using OpenSSL sources, the various advantages and disadvantages associated with them, the extent up to which students have been benefited from them, and the various problems or issues faced by the students while accessing the OpenSSL sources. Methodology. For data collection, a survey was done under which a questionnaire that was developed in Google Forms was distributed to the students. I received a total of 150 responses. As we can see, most of the participants lie in the age group of 22 to 25 years, and maximum participation are from the females. Awareness of using OpenSSL sources among the students. Most of the students are moderately aware about the OpenSSL sources, and talking about the duration for which they use the OpenSSL sources, they have been using it for about 1 to 2 years. That stands for the maximum number of students. Frequency of using OpenSSL sources. A similar percentage of 43.5% is observed for the students that use OpenSSL sources occasionally and almost every time. If we talk about the preferred place of using OpenSSL sources among the students, most of the students prefer to access them from home, followed by the campus premises. Reasons for using OpenSSL sources. The various reasons for which the students were using OpenSSL sources are for self-obtention, to prepare for exams, for current affairs, for making their assignments. And among the resources used by them are, they rely upon e-journals, e-books, e-theses, directories, e-print archive, digital repositories, search engines, and blogs. Advantages of using OpenSSL sources. The various advantages of OpenSSL sources as put forward by the students they have mentioned that they are easily accessible, which most of our students have answered. That stands for 52.2%, followed by they are reached to larger population, they save the time, they are free, and they can be put to immediate. Talking about the disadvantages of using open source sources, the following disadvantages are associated with them. These are copyright issues, additional formalities, sustainability, doubtful quality, and processing charges sometimes which are involved with them. The problems faced while using open source resources by the students. When using open source resources, the students could come across the following problems. These are identification of good open source resources among a lot of information sources, their relevance, information overload that we can gain from search engines or other sources, their lack of skills to assess them, and one major issue is the internet problem. Talking about the satisfaction of students with open source sources and their usage, we can see that mostly the students are satisfied. Conclusion. Most of the students have moderate level of awareness regarding the use of open source resources. The most preferred place of using open source resources is from home and campus premises. The main reasons that have come out for using open source resources are updating oneself and to prepare for exams. E-books and search engines are the most popular among the students. The main advantage of open source resources according to the students is that they are easily accessible. Doubtful quality and copyright issues are among the major disadvantages of students, as the students think. The major issues encountered by them while using open source resources are the identification of good sources and information overload. Most of the students are satisfied with them and their usability. With this, I end my presentation. I thank you all for giving me such an opportunity. Thanks.
Thank you, Shail. I think this is a true example of e-learning management. So, is Dr. Meghnath there? I think she has the same problem. Okay, next is, I think, Mr. Uddolok Shah. Mr. Shah, are you there? Mr. Uddolok Shah?
Audible?
Yes, you are audible. Next one is Mr. Shubhashish Chatterjee.
As I school library, and since 11 months we are working in an online mode of education, and I will be putting some light on my experiences in for this long time. So my plan of talk is like, I will discuss on the several benefits of e-libraries, different ways to make e-libraries.
Sorry, Uddolok, sorry to interrupt you. Are you sharing your screen?
No, sir.
Then may I, for you on your behalf, may I share your screen or your presentation?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Is it visible? Is it visible, Mr. Shah? Okay, proceed.
Okay. Sir, next slide. Yes. So I plan to speak on the following topics today, that the several benefits of the school of the e-libraries, the benefits the e-libraries are having for the children, for the e-learners and the faculty members of an institute. The next I will talk about the different ways to make e-learning successful, the combined tasks of e-learners, the librarians, the faculties and the authorities, and how to present the e-libraries and how the libraries are supporting in this role of education. Yes, sir, next slide. So there are several benefits of e-libraries, as we all know. So in context of the users, the e-learners, I would like to put some light. So digital and e-libraries facilitate in the preservation of documents, as we all know. Digital and e-libraries are accessed through the web at anywhere, at any time, can support advanced search with features like better display, ranking based on relevance can be shown to the seekers, the information seekers, the e-learners and the faculty members, and they can get relevant information at right time. Enhanced access to the users can be provided by sharing information of similar e-libraries with favorable metadata and information exchange protocols. Provided we are having proper metadata, we can use the e-platform and e-library to share those information in a more particular way, in more particular time. An electronic document may be provided simultaneously to many requests for the access. The contents can be easily provided in various formats like text, animation, graphics, audio or video. Like as the same topic can be presented in different ways. It can be an animation or in the mode of some graphics, videos, or can only be the audio shared on a e-platform. The e-libraries can also serve better with respect to the current programs and services, current contents, accommodating the native language text, the narratives, enriched institutional repositories, lectures like NPTEL, courses, videos, etc., enrich the e-libraries as a whole. So there is a holistic development of the e-libraries. Next slide, sir. Different ways to make e-learning successful. E-library materials can be lent to more relaxed conditions on time to return, imposing no fees to the borrowers, because they may be retrieved, as electronic materials can be retrieved without any loss. So there may be some relaxation on the part of the library to the learners. Making e-learners aware of modern tools and techniques to search the relevant materials in a library. Making faculties aware of the modern resources and techniques suitable to the e-learners so that they can include in their teaching learning the techniques and facilities to facilitate in the learning environment, teaching learning environment. The combined workshops for librarians, faculties, e-learners to imbibe knowledge of the new techniques. Active collaboration between the librarian and the faculties can be mutual benefit towards building effective e-courses and students in the students' interest in e-libraries. So the collaboration between the librarian and the faculty members would help the e-libraries to be an enriched one. Since a success begets another success, so examples of flourishing librarian teacher can lead to a demand of other similar packs throughout an institution. So when a teacher is collaborating with a librarian in facilitating a e-resource, and the resource becomes a popular one, a helpful one for the e-learners, that instills another success that drives that a demand for creation of new that kind of e-resources, which needs to be created again and again in a continuous way, so that helps in imparting education to the learners. E-libraries can keep distant learners motivated with special efforts, publish articles highlighting student activities, provide relaxation readings at intervals to increase their reading and knowledge gathering habits, so that distant learners can feel immensely connected and relieved. So this is also very important, where we can feel that the learners are very distant, are isolated from their peer groups. They cannot physically interact with their fellow friends and their teachers. They can't see their teachers and they may be feeling isolated. So when the teachers take the responsibility of interacting, the librarians take the initiative of sharing materials with the learners, it helps the learners to feel connected and improves their interesting level. Next slide, sir. Combined tasks of e-learners, e-libraries, faculties, authorities. A comprehensive planning process is necessary by means of shared resources, risks, and control. So whenever we are creating e-resources, a planning is required, because the resource has to be generated in a continuous way for a long duration for supporting that kind of education. Continuity needs to be maintained over time to develop an integrated curriculum and resource base and technology-driven instruction and learning program. It involves e-libraries, tools, and technologies in both synchronous and asynchronous online learning programs. Now, e-libraries is a form of asynchronous mode of education, and that can be accommodated with the synchronous one with some sophistication, with some technologies, so that the physical aspect of the teaching learning can also be helpful with the e-library. The library can help with the synchronous form of learning too. Collaborative relationship in improving the quality of library instruction institution, such as designing library instruction for users, developing reference consultation services, collection development, and sharing resources. So a collaborative relationship will help in developing the e-library infrastructure. The universities and authorities can fund programs for awareness of e-learning techniques and resources, provide guidelines that defines specific roles and responsibilities to the librarians and to the faculty members as well. For collaboration, assign consultant roles for faculty and librarians during collaboration to enhance teaching, learning, research, and develop research skills for students. Develop regulations to encourage faculty to share and introduce more information resources with library and vice versa. Develop incentive policies for faculty libraries and learners who participate in collaborative activities. So that would be our incentive, and that will motivate, keep the motivation level of high on for the faculties and librarians to promote effective collaboration models for the librarians, faculties, and the e-libraries. And I will conclude with a note on how to the present libraries are supporting. How the e-libraries are supporting the present scenario and how they are facilitating the online education and e-learning. Many educational and research organizations have been supporting e-learning.
Next slide.
Yes, sir. Many educational and research organizations have been supporting e-learning in different innovative ways, where the authorities are trying to test their effectiveness of collaborating approaches. Some examples are IOOW State University, University of Utah, California State University, Handel Bin, Mohammed Smart University in United Arab Emirates, National University of Nigeria, and in India, Space Application Center, IITs, National Digital Library of India are the examples. National Digital Library of India is providing authentic resources, which we all know, which include exam materials for schools and college students, scholarly publications, links to talks and meetings. However, a lot more needs to be done, mostly at the authority levels, in Indian perspective, to see some meaningful and fruitful connections between the faculties, e-libraries, and learners. Thank you.
Is there any suggestion for Mr. Shah? Otherwise, I would request to Mr. Subhashish Chatterjee.
Sir.
Please do not read out the slides. Okay.
Yes, sir.
We are running late. Yes, Mr. Chatterjee, proceed.
Sir, am I audible?
Yes, you are audible and visible too.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Okay, myself Subhashish. Good afternoon, everyone. Myself Subhashish Chatterjee, the librarian of Central Library Elite Institute of Engineering and Management. And my topic is the role of academic libraries in e-learning in India, the strategies for the new normal. In modern days, libraries are not only confined to the name of storehouse of books. It is popularly known as information center dynamic services. So the normal library operation, like cataloging, acquisition, circulation, all related library services now can be easily done by the help of internet services. Moreover, the libraries are also involved in the teaching learning process, and the traditional methods of classroom teaching have been transformed to the online teaching learning method. And due to this COVID-19 pandemic in the year of 2020, we all know that e-learning method has become very, very important and popular in all over the world, and was the only path to continue the teaching learning process during the lockdown situation, and libraries can play a very important role in this respect. Now, I am focusing on some e-learning initiatives in India. I'm starting from the background. In India, the first e-learning has been started in the mid-90s. That is, it's narrowed in 84. By the government of India as a computer literacy project for school, it's namely CLASS, C-L-A-S-S, the Computer Literacy and Social on School. And since then, many other initiatives have been taken by the government of India and other private ventures to promote e-learning in distance education and also in literacy education in India. And some major examples are countrywide classroom by UGC and NISAD in 1984. The NISAD is now is obsolete, but UGC is still running. Online education by NIIT, is a private organization, in 1986. Telecasting educational program started by IGNU in 1991. Dan Darshan educational channel by IGNU, Poshar Bharati and Government of India in 2000. The first educational satellite, EduSat, in 2001 to facilitate long distance learning. Ekalabbo is another venture by IIT Bombay in 2004. eGAN course, a national digital repository by IGNU in 2006. And I would like to say that Mr. Sujan Bundu Chakraborty, assistant librarian of Benoar University, already told about more and more about eGAN course. And for the kind information, I am also a student of IGNU, and I also took help for eGAN course and study materials of IGNU to crack my net and say. And next one is NPTEL. NPTEL by MHRD in 2006. NDLI project sponsored by National Mission of Education and ICT under Ministry of Education in 2006. So these are some initiatives in the previous years in India. Now the definition of e-learning. E-learning is the general term used to refer to a form learning in which the trainer and student are separated by space or time, but the gap between the two is bridged through the use of online technologies. The communication platform, there are two types of platform: scheduled delivery platform and online delivery platform. In scheduled delivery platform, the information is provided through large video display, virtual classroom. You all know like Zoom platform, Google Classroom, Socrates, Quizlet, Animoto, Seesaw, etc., etc. And the online delivery platform, in this delivery mode platform, the information can be accessed 24/7, that is for any time, from anywhere and any place, with the help of internet connections, web-based learning, uniform resources, and on-demand CD service, CD-ROM services are some example of this delivery mode. Besides the internet and network tools, there are some another tools in e-learning process which is very helpful in teaching learning process to interact between the learner and the teacher. These are like emails, blogging tools, bulletin boards, web forms, wikis, instant messaging service, internet telephonies to call phone calls and video calls without bearing any extra charge for long distance. Types of e-learning. There are main three types of e-learnings: synchronous e-learning, asynchronous e-learning, and cohort learning. Synchronous e-learning, here the instructor and the learner both are present in the same time, that is in the real time, but maybe or may not be in the same place. That is traditional classroom learning, and nowadays we are going, all going on in this type of learning, that is Google Classroom, different types of online learning is in come under in this type of learning. Asynchronous learning, in this type of learning, the instruction and learners do not participate at the same time. That is in the real time, and often there is no instructor at all. Cohort learning is the blending of synchronous and asynchronous. That is the learning includes all the educational activities such as readings, video lectures, assignments, etc., etc., among instruction and learners within a stipulated course of time. This model popular in higher education system using platform like SWAM, NPTEL, etc. Now, the main focus in academic libraries in e-learning activities. Recently, the most of the academic libraries have been transformed to the digital libraries. Rather, more than is hybrid libraries. Hybrid library is the library like where you get all the facilities of printed materials, e-materials, and digital learning process also. So libraries user can easily access the e-content subscribed by them and updated by academic library to facilitate the teaching learning process. Whereas the librarians helps to provide information regarding teaching, learning, and research as a subject academician. Moreover, some academic libraries are taking initiatives to perform as an e-learning and training center. and some major online courseware, and where the academic library served as an e-learning center to provide this platform. The examples are Swarm, NPTEL, InFlipNet, EPG Patsala, Vidyamitra, Khan Academy, Coursera, Virtual Labs, and many more. Swarm is the Sanskrit acronym. The full name is Study Waves of Active Learnings for Young Aspiring Minds. It is the venture of MHRD, that is Ministry of Human Resource Development, presently in the Ministry of Education. It provides the courses on MOOC system, MOOCs platform, and started in 2017. NPTEL is the National Program on Technology Enhanced Learning. It is also a venture of MHRD and by 7 IITs in 2003. InFlipNet, you all know that InFlipNet is a venture of UGC, started as a inter-university center in 1991. And it is independently act since 1996 as a repository and data network center for higher education. EPG Patsala. EPG Patsala is also a venture of MHRD and National Mission of Education and ICT. It provides also e-content, text, and video audio materials and online courses. And Vidyamitra is also an online learning portal of National Mission of Education. And there are also all others, the Khan Academy, Coursera, and Virtual Labs. Now the concluding suggestive part. For the COVID-19 pandemic situation, we all know that e-learning has become more important and get faster acceptance in all over the world to continue the teaching learning process beyond the wall of the normal classrooms. The academic libraries are always involved to provide information and knowledge to users, whether it is traditional classroom learning process or e-learning process. And finally, an important thing to mention that though e-learning and e-contents are very useful for necessary support for the distant learners, and especially in the pandemic situation, but it never be the replacement for the traditional learning process, as all of us would not be able to or not try to read or continue to study with soft copies using the internet or web resources for long time. And it also may affect our eyes and health. And that is why it is always suggested and concluded e-learning is very useful, but only with the traditional learning side by side. An academic library is an inseparable part for traditional learning or e-learning. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chatterjee.
Thank you, sir.
So if there is no question, then I would like to request Mr. Hafizul Mondal to share his presentation. Yes, Hafizul, proceed. You are visible. You are not audible. Abhijit, you are not audible. Still, you are not audible. Try to use without your earphone. Say something. No.
Okay, am I right now? Audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Sorry, sir, I am connected from the two hours.
No issue, no issue. Proceed.
Okay, two different devices. Okay. My topic is role of library supporting e-learning and real-life assistance to its users. Abstract. Technological advancement is guaranteeing convincing for us. Virtually each step of our lives, beginning with online searching, ride-sharing service, and in fact, food order and delivery. To kick things up a notch, technology has currently created its place into the globe of education in what we termed a decision e-learning. E-learning or electric learning may be a manner for students to coach themselves, sometime by mistreatment the net. It acts as a platform that connects academics and students from all across the world. During this paper, shortly mentioned on the conception of e-learning with impact of e-resource and services on educational activity and analysis, and conjointly mentioned on how our library support and provides e-learning with the issues and benefits. Introduction. In the competitive environment, the new practice of education and training has developed into the concept of e-learning environment. Objective of the study, to review basic conception of concerning e-learning, to understand the explanation why e-learning is vital during these situations. Relations among e-learning, teaching in library, and knowledge science. Basic steps to coming up with associate implementing an e-learning program in LISS. Impact of e-resource and services on educational activity and LISS. The ways in which of supporting and provides e-learning through library. Finally, benefits and issues of e-learning. What is e-learning? E-learning, conjointly said as an online learning or electronic learning, is that the acquisition of data that take place through electronic technology and media. In straightforward language, e-learning is outlined as learning that enabled electronically. Typically, e-learning is conducted on the net. However, students will access their learning materials online at any place, anytime. E-learning most frequently takes place within the style of online courses, online degrees, and online programs. Why e-learning? Online learning has varied benefits over ancient learning ways. A number of these embody of the chance for college kids to form use of self-paced learning and to decide on their own learning environments. In addition, e-learning is cost related to ancient lecture rooms and educations. The following steps also follow in coming up with associate degree implementing and e-learning programs in LIS by Tripathi and Jeevan. Need and demand analysis for online programs, course and credits of the programs, intended audience, hardware and software requirement, internet access, cost, institutional mindset, assessment and awarding marks or grading, selecting of learning management software or virtual learning environment, orientation, user awareness programs, staff training, development, evaluation, finally, maintenance of the system. Impact of e-resource service on education activity. The 21st century, data technology had brought speedy change in education. The standard teaching and learning is step by step moving towards online. The construct of digital library, virtual library, electronic library came into gift scenario. Electronic data resources have several benefits over ancient data resources. For teaching and learning, electronic resource square meters are out there in net-enabled medium. Thousands of development witnessed within the recent year in e-publishing. Publishers have an interest in several programs like publication price, dynamic audience, dynamic user exception, right management, and archiving. Libraries provide through digital library user online in service, e-library, have developed since computer were initially utilized in education. To collection, a good sort of material in digital form, book, journal, manuscript, supply of knowledge concerning the library service and assortment to remote user, access to online library catalogs, service online tutorials, networking and emerging technologies to support and enhance all aspects of library and basic operational activity. Institutional depository, e-learning through open access, and through library website. Here I saw the picture, Rakpur Rashtraguru Surendranath College website. By this website, there is a lots of links, Swam, Neptel, Ipatsala, So, Doge. By this, library can provide e-learning facility to its users. Advantage of e-learning. It is a very efficient way of delivering courses online. Everyone who are part of this student, part-time student or working full-time can take advantage of web-based learning. Web-based learning promotes active and independent learning. As you have access to the next 24/7, you can train yourself anytime, any from anywhere. Conclusion, e-learning is unlikely to replace face-to-face training and education. It is specially changing into associate necessary further delivery methodology, and it offers new learning opportunities to several people's learning is a necessary methodology of delivering data training program. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Mondal.
Yes, sir.
So may I request the audience or the participants to share their views or comment regarding the presentation of Mr. Mondal. Okay. So with it, we are going to end the technical session 3. We have total 19 contributed papers, among which 16 are there who have presented over here. One among these are virtually, truly virtually, that we have shared is video. And now we are moving to the final valedictory session. So may I request you all to start your video so that we can take a snapshot of the entire participants. Thank you all. You may stop your videos. So in a validity session, I think one of our senior teacher from the management, Dr. Nilay Kaur Chaudhary, is there. I request Dr. Kaur Chaudhary to chair the session. Though it is a sudden one, but I think he will not deprive me. So with the permission from the chair, it is assumed that Dr. Kaur Chaudhary is chairing the session. So with the permission from the chair, I would like to share a video from our governing body president that we supposed to start in the very first inaugural session, but due to some technical issues, we cannot share it. So let me allow to share the shared his talk. Though he start with very good morning, eventually if we can show it at the proper time, that the word is quite right, but still it is 5:37. Just ignore it, the first word of him.
Sarip, am I audible?
Yes, you are audible. And you are chairing the session, sir.
Okay, thank you for honoring me.
So, with your permission,
may I... From the very beginning.
Yeah,
so
that issue.
I was with Joydeep from the very initiative work of this UGCCP-funded national conference on e-learning experiences, apps and tools. The program has been organized by Central Library and Internal Quality Assurance Cells, Barakpur Ashtaguru Surinath College. There are Dr. K.S. Kuppuswamy, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science from Pondicherry University. There were Dr. Sushant Banerjee, University Librarian of West Bengal State University. And I heard from our Joydeep that there are 19 papers have been submitted today. That is a very large number of papers. And the session was very good. I was very much enthusiastic about the e-learning process, and I will apply and request all the members to go through the e-learning processes of NPTEL and others which have been discussed here. So again, thanks to the organizing committee, and I hope that such kind of programs will happen very often. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.